So in the last video, I reported that this radio had a sort of crackling noise that I associated with silver mica disease. And after looking at the schematic, I found out that this IF can right here has two embedded mica capacitors in it, much like a slug-tuned IF transformer would. And so I removed the can, went through it, rebuilt it, put it back together, and it was a total fail. It didn't work. The radio didn't work at all after that, as a matter of fact. But what makes matters worse is that I found out that the crackling noise didn't have anything to do with the IF can. Instead, it had to do with this coupling capacitor right here. Pretty melty there. It was actually arcing internally, which is what was causing that noise and also causing low volume. And so I was pretty pissed off after that, but I wasn't ready to throw in the towel yet. I wanted to find a part set so that I could use the chassis and just sort of get a fresh start. And that's exactly what I did. Let me show you what I got. This radio is also about the same vintage. As you can see, the styling is quite a bit different. It looks a little scruffy. This dial, or this faceplate, whatever you want to call it here, is metal and it's pretty rusty. And I don't know what kind of industrial grade paint is across the top here, this green paint that somebody got on here, but it does not come off. But anyways, let me show you the back. There are a couple of key differences I want to point out from the other chassis. The first thing that jumps out at you is that this one does not use a loop antenna like the other one does. Instead, it uses just a hank of wire right here, which is tied to. Oh, let me get a flashlight here. You're not going to be able to see anything. There we go. Back there, it's got an antenna coil, which the other one doesn't have. I have no problem with that. An antenna coil's fine, along with a piece of wire. I do have an external antenna that I can connect it to. However, the most important thing for me at least is that the IF transformers on this do not have embedded mica type sheets inside. They're actually just standard four-wire IF transformers. Nothing special about them. So right now I'm kind of on the fence though as to what I want to do. Do I use this chassis, which will, by the way, bolt right into that other cabinet? Do I use that chassis and just swap it out, or do I restore this radio, and just put the other one on the shelf until I come up with yet another chassis? I have to admit that when I compare the two cabinets, this radio right here is quite a bit better looking. It's a lot more stylish. I do like the white on red. However, as I said, I don't know what I would do about getting this paint off, and with this rusty grill here, man, I don't know. I think I'd actually have to sand that down and repaint it, which means I'd also have to repaint the numbers on here because those are white. It would be a lot of work cosmetically to get this back together, but when I'm done, I might have a better looking radio. So I don't know. I'm gonna have to sleep on that. Am I gonna restore that, or am I just gonna use it for the chassis? Speaking of the chassis, the seller that sold it to me said that it just has a loud hum, so we know that's filter capacitors. So again, I'm going to sleep on it and see if I want to restore that. At any rate, I do have to restore the chassis no matter what because, even if I use it in the other cabinet, it still has to be gone over. So, yeah, in the next video, I imagine I'm going to be pulling the chassis and having a closer look.